Elecrow approached me about their new Raspberry Pi laptop computer, and I said, sure, send me one. It's this one. So it's not really a laptop computer because it doesn't include the computer part like this. And on the package, it actually just says monitor with keyboard because it doesn't actually contain a computer. So where do I stick the Raspberry Pi computer? Not in the top. And not in the bottom either. So it comes with this adapter board, which can fit a Pi 4 or a Pi 5. Kind of hard to push on here. And then you need this little bridge connector here, which connects to one of the USB ports. Now these ports are arranged differently on a Pi 5, but the middle connector is exactly the same, so it fits both. And now that plugs into the side of the computer, and it's hard to push with the three connectors engaging at the same time. And so this whole thing just kind of sticks out the side, supported strictly by the connectors, though if it's on the bench, this rests flat on there too. They also have a separate adapter for the Jetson Nano that plugs on here, and it also plugs in here. And the laptop's battery powers the Pi, it just turned on. And I'm logged into a text console, so let's start the graphical environment. And I can use the touchpad here to do things, but I can also plug a mouse in here because inside here is also a USB hub, so I can use my real mouse here. And while this is not ideal for taking to a coffee shop, I appreciate for experiments that I still have access to all of my connector pins here, and this connector, as well as these ports here. Although the top USB port here is blocked. If this was a Pi 5, this USB connector would be over here and be fine, and this Ethernet connector is a bit lower, so that would still work. Now the audio connector on here is blocked, but this laptop computer also provides a USB audio device, which is how the sound gets out. So listing the USB devices, we've got a root hub, some USB audio device, that's probably inside the laptop computer, a USB keyboard inside the laptop computer, Microsoft optical mouse, that's this one here, some 7-port hub probably inside the laptop computer, another hub, and this is probably inside the Pi. So now I got it playing with the internal speakers, which they're okay, but they don't sound great. Although this thing does have a headphone jack, so I guess I could use external speakers or headphones. Now this board is just all through connectors, so I could just replace it with three separate cables. So I got a short USB-C cable, micro HDMI to HDMI, and then HDMI to mini HDMI, which is what this has got, and a USB-A to USB-A cable, and that works just fine. I can use this like I could with this board here. And I think I actually prefer the cables because I don't have to worry about accidentally breaking this off. I just wish it came with three short cables that were just the right ones. So I switched over using cables to a Raspberry Pi 3A Plus, which has got a different connector arrangement. And I've got a couple of servos powered off the Pi, which is powered off the Elecrow laptop computer, and the camera module on there, also showing up on the laptop display. That's what Pis are all about, is hooking stuff up to them. So that's running off of this internal battery, which this guy is completely unaware of, so it can't really tell me. But there's a button right here I can push, and that shows me the battery status. It says it's got a 5-amp-hour battery inside, which, I don't know, it can't be a very large battery because this is not very heavy. There's also buttons for adjusting brightness, as well as the display thing on here, where you can adjust things like you can on any other monitor. With this thing mostly being a display and keyboard, it should work with just a regular PC as well. And there's my display now. And I can use it here as well as with the touchpad. Although I don't know how to do a drag with this touchpad. Oh, there we go. And I can play that in here.
Jack, so I guess I could use external
coming
speakers
out of the
or
speakers on this thing here.
Or is it just all through connect?
And of course, I can type on it too. Now, my regular laptop is getting to be almost 9 years old, and it makes me wonder, maybe I should just buy a mini PC and use it with that instead of replacing my laptop computer. Now, in addition to the USB-A port, there's also a USB-C port on the right, and I just plugged a second mouse into that just to make sure that would actually work, so I can move the mouse with that and with this one here. But that's not what this USB-C port is for. So my iPad 10 has USB-C and it's able to mirror display on here and also use an external keyboard and mouse, so I can actually operate the iPad a bit like a laptop computer and of course use the keyboard to type. So I've been playing around testing this, but the user interface on this is really set up for touchscreen, so the mouse isn't always intuitive how it works. And in terms of typing, I could just use a Bluetooth keyboard like that with the iPad. And the screen isn't that much bigger, and the sound coming out of this is not as good as the sound that actually comes out of the iPad. But that's not actually what that USB port is for, because with the latest smartphones and tablets, they can give you a full desktop environment if you use one of those dongles that Mac users are all familiar with that plugs into the USB-C and gives you a display and keyboard interface. Well, this laptop essentially does what one of those dongles do, and so you can take your latest smartphones, plug it into that, and they'll give you a desktop environment, which I think is a very cool feature. It's just, I don't have any gadgets that new and fancy to try that with. And curiosity got the better of me. Just exactly what is inside that thing? I hate it when they hide screws behind the sticker. Oh, there's a whole little lid on here. Oh, that's why it wouldn't pop apart. Well, those batteries are a little bit bigger than I thought they would be. And this space up here almost looks like space for an NVMe drive. It's got a mount for it here. But there's no socket for it, so they must have changed their mind about something. And these things here are the speakers that sound so tinny. And it still works. I was starting to worry as I was prying it apart that this might end like a Jerry Rigs Everything review. And it's occurred to me, you could just buy a battery-powered monitor and a Bluetooth keyboard, and it would do mostly the same thing. But having it integrated with the touchpad and the USB thing for the phones and for the Pis on this side, and being able to just close it to protect the screen and keyboard is kind of a cool feature. Now they're gonna have a Kickstarter for this laptop thingy, which I don't fully agree with because it's not like they're a small startup that really need the Kickstarter. They've already developed this thing and they certainly don't need the Kickstarter funding. So like a lot of Chinese companies, they're just using Kickstarter as a marketing tool. The early bird price they say is gonna be somewhere around $120, but they haven't fully decided that yet. And these interface boards, that may cost a little bit extra to get those. And the cables I was using, those are all mine, not supplied with the computer. But it does come with this non-standard 12-volt power adapter for charging it up. So thanks to Elecrow for providing me with this gadget free of charge. I think I'll have a use for it once in a while. And I thought you might be interested in knowing about it too.